Fontainebleau, is a commune in the metropolitan area of Paris, France. It is located south-southeast of the center of Paris. Fontainebleau is a sub-prefecture of the Seine-et-Marne department, and it is the seat of the arrondissement of Fontainebleau. The commune has the largest land area in the Île-de-France region. It is the only one to cover a larger area than Paris itself. Fontainebleau, together with the neighboring commune of Avon and three other smaller communes, form an urban area of 39,713 inhabitants, according to the 2001 census. This urban area is a satellite of Paris. Fontainebleau is renowned for the large and scenic forest of Fontainebleau, a favorite weekend getaway for Parisians, as well as for the historic Château de Fontainebleau, which once belonged to the kings of France. It is also the home of INSEAD, one of the world's most elite business schools. Inhabitants of Fontainebleau are sometimes called Bellefontaines. Fontainebleau has been recorded in different Latinized forms, such as Fontainebleau d. Fontainebleau, Fontainebleau in the 12th and 13th centuries, with Fontainebleau being recorded in 1137. It became Fontainebleau in the 17th century, which gave rise to the name of the inhabitants as Bellefontaines. The name originates as a medieval composite of two words, fontaine meaning spring, or fountainhead, followed by a person's Germanic name Blaiswald. This hamlet was endowed with a royal hunting lodge and a chapel by Louis VII in the middle of the 12th century. A century later, Louis IX, also called St. Louis, who held Fontainebleau in high esteem and referred to it as his wilderness, had a country house and a hospital constructed there. Philip the Fair was born there in 1268 and died there in 1314. In all, 34 sovereigns, from Louis VI, the Fat, 1081 to 1137, to Napoleon III, 1808 to 1873, spent time at Fontainebleau. The connection between the town of Fontainebleau and the French monarchy was reinforced with the transformation of the royal country house into a true royal palace, the Palace of Fontainebleau. This was accomplished by the great builder king, Francis I, 1494-1547, who, in the largest of his many construction projects, reconstructed, expanded, and transformed the royal chateau at Fontainebleau into a residence that became his favorite, as well as the residence of his mistress, Anne, Duchess of Aitam. From the 16th to the 18th century, every monarch, from Francis I to Louis XV, made important renovations at the Palace of Fontainebleau, including demolitions, reconstructions, additions, and embellishments of various descriptions, all of which endowed it with a character that is a bit heterogeneous, but harmonious nonetheless. On October 18, 1685, Louis XIV signed the Edict of Fontainebleau there. Also known as the revocation of the Edict of Nantes, this royal fiat reversed the permission granted to the Huguenots in 1598 to worship publicly in specified locations and hold certain other privileges. The result was that a large number of Protestants were forced to convert to the Catholic faith, killed, or forced into exile, mainly in the Low Countries, Prussia and in England. The 1762 Treaty of Fontainebleau, a secret agreement between France and Spain concerning the Louisiana Territory in North America, was concluded here. Also, preliminary negotiations, held before the 1763 Treaty of Paris was signed, ending the Seven Years' War, were at Fontainebleau. During the French Revolution, Fontainebleau was temporarily renamed Fontaine-la-Montagne, meaning fountain by the mountain. The mountain referred to is the series of rocky formations located in the forest of Fontainebleau. On October 29, 1807, Manuel Godoy, Chancellor to the Spanish King, Charles IV and Napoleon signed the Treaty of Fontainebleau, which authorized the passage of French troops through Spanish territories so that they might invade Portugal. On June 20, 1812, Pope Pius VII arrived at the Château of Fontainebleau, after a secret transfer from Savona, accompanied by his personal physician, Balthazar Clarez. In poor health, the Pope was the prisoner of Napoleon, and he remained in his genteel prison at Fontainebleau for 19 months. From June 1812 until January 23, 1814, the Pope never left his apartments. On April 20, 1814, Napoleon Bonaparte, shortly before his first abdication, bid farewell to the old guard, the renowned Grognards, Gripers, who had served with him since his very first campaigns, in the White Horse Courtyard, La Cour du Cheval Blanc, at the Palace of Fontainebleau. The courtyard has since been renamed the Courtyard of Goodbyes, according to contemporary sources, The occasion was very moving. The 1814 Treaty of Fontainebleau stripped Napoleon of his powers, but not his title as Emperor of the French, and sent him into exile on Elba. Until the 19th century, Fontainebleau was a village and a suburb of Avon. Later, it developed as an independent residential city. For the 1924 Summer Olympics, the town played host to the riding portion of the modern pentathlon event. This event took place near a golf course. In July and August 1946, the town hosted the Franco-Vietnamese Conference, intended to find a solution to the long-contested struggle for Vietnam's independence from France, but the conference ended in failure. Fontainebleau also hosted the General Staff of the Allied Forces in Central Europe, Allied Forces Center of Cent, and the Land Forces Command, Landcent. The Air Forces Command, Aircent, was located nearby at Camp Guynemer. These facilities were in place from the inception of NATO until France's partial withdrawal from NATO in 1967 when the United States returned those bases to French control. NATO moved Aircent to Brunsum in the Netherlands and Aircent to Ramstein in West Germany. Note that the Supreme Headquarters Allied Powers Europe, also known as SHAPE, was located at Roquencourt, west of Paris, quite a distance from Fontainebleau. In 2008, the Men's World Championship of Real Tennis, Jeux de Paume, was held in the tennis court of the Château. The Real Tennis World Championship is field-distance sport and Fontainebleau has one of only two active courts in France. Fontainebleau is a popular tourist destination. Each year, 300,000 people visit the palace and more than 13 million people visit the forest. The forest of Fontainebleau surrounds the town and dozens of nearby villages. It is protected by France's Office National des Forêts, and it is recognized as a French national park. It is managed in order that its wild plants and trees, such as the rare service tree of Fontainebleau, and its populations of birds, mammals, and butterflies, can be conserved. It is a former royal hunting park often visited by hikers and horse riders. The forest is also well regarded for bouldering and is particularly popular among climbers, as the biggest developed area of that kind in the world. The Royal Château de Fontainebleau is a large palace where the kings of France took their ease. It is also the site where the French royal court, from 1528 onwards, entertained the body of new ideas that became known as the Renaissance. The European, and historic, campus of the INSEAD Business School is located at the edge of Fontainebleau, by the Lycée François Cooper, and INSEAD students live in local accommodations around the Fontainebleau area, and especially in the surrounding towns. The graves of G.I. Gurdjieff and Catherine Mansfield can be found in the cemetery at Avon. Fontainebleau is served by two stations on the Transilien Paris Lyon rail line, Fontainebleau-Avon and Thomery. Fontainebleau-Avon station, the station closest to the center of Fontainebleau, is located near the dividing line between the commune of Fontainebleau and the commune of Avon, on the Avon side of the border. Fontainebleau is twinned with the following cities. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.